Lucia and her two sons are Mexican migrants, newly arrived in the US with dreams of better things. Dreams that are very quickly dashed. In squalid conditions, she must prevent Max and his younger brother Leo from despair.
A lo del trabajo.
Te acompañamos.
No se puede,
Max. Nos cambiamos y vamos.
No se puede, ya hemos hablado de eso.
So while she works in part-time jobs to earn some money, they live out imaginary adventures within the apparent safety of their four walls. The actress who plays Lucia says she hopes that the message of this film can reach the widest possible audience.
I think the more important thing to me is in Mexico, maybe this movie, it's not considered to kids. Maybe it's for a teenager or adult, and have this movie in generation for kids and have this reaction of the kids, and they understand this movie, the cinema.
Los Lobos allows us to explore the dislocating human effect of migration. It's a theme that's also explored in the film I Dream of Singapore, which shows the viewer a very different aspect of what it means to be a migrant.
Because this is a migrant's journey in reverse. When first we meet Feroz, he's in Singapore, struggling to earn enough to survive and far from his family back home in Bangladesh. Through his eyes, we see what modern materialism metes out to many migrants. Poverty, desperation, and in Feroz's case, the loss of his working visa when his health deteriorates, which mean he must return home. The film's director says he hopes the audience will realize what migration can mean for so many people.
I hope to humanize the migrant worker, to see them as a human and someone with a family, loved ones, hopes and dreams like us all, and not to see them as a statistic.
Many migrants hope their journeys will take them to a better life. In these two films, we are offered a contrary view, one where the destination is not a promised land. Dominic Kane, Al Jazeera, at the Berlin Film Festival.